So, for our next talk, we welcome Professor Balbodel on Jos Juris Application of 1586 in Modern View of Ingenious Algorithm for Calculating Tables of the Sine Function.
Thank you all very much for inviting me to this beautiful conference. And also, I thank you for listening to this presentation, which is not at all in the mode of many other presentations, including the last one. However, my presentation is of historic nature, and it will shed light on the formation of the first sine table of the sine function. And the sine function, you all know, is essential in celestial mechanics. So to know how the sine function came into being is not surface. In the years of 1586 to 1592, the Swiss instrument maker, watchmaker, and mathematician Jost Bürgi devised and documented an ingenious algorithm for efficiently and precisely calculating the table of the sine function. The manuscript, Fundamentum Astronomiae, was explaining this method, was known to exist, but it had been considered as lost until 2013, when Menzel Focus in the university library. Oh, is it better now? Menzel Focus in the university library of Wrocław, now in Poland, rediscovered this manuscript. And in this presentation, we discuss Bürgi's algorithm, referred to as Artificium or Kunstbild, with the tools of modern linear algebra. We consider the difference table of the sine function and use matrices and eigenvalue problems, and we develop a theory of the algorithm of the rate of convergence. So what is Bürgi doing? How can I get a pointer?
Pointer is this, just here. This one? Okay, you see? Try it out and I will do it.
Okay. Yes, so what the algorithm does is to calculate those sine values for a certain n, namely the sines of the multiples of 90 degrees over n, j equals 1 to n. So this is a sine table, and Bürgi suggests n equals 9, so the step of this table is 10 degrees. He also mentioned n equals 90, meaning every degree of the right angle. We will just use a much simpler algorithm, n equals 3. Sine 30 degrees is 1/2, sine 60 degrees is root of 3 over 2, sine 90 degrees is 1. So, but let's have a look at Bürgi's table, which was rediscovered. Here on the left-hand side, we see the argument, 10 degrees, 20 degrees, and so on, 90 degrees. And here we see the data of the table. And Bürgi obviously starts at the right end of the table with an approximation of multiples of a sine to be calculated, starting with 0 and ending with 12. So he wants to do all his calculations with integers, small integers if possible. So he starts with small integers, and this is actually a difference table. So these should be the final results, and then there's a first difference, second difference, third difference, and so on. We can check here, for instance, By the way, he's using the hexadecimal system, which was customary at that time whenever angles were involved. So even the salary was, for instance, documented in the hexadecimal system. So this is 1 times 60 plus 3. This is 1 times 60 plus 1. And 63 minus 61 is 2. So here we see the difference of the previous column. But let's go back to our example, our simple example, starting with an eightfold, the signs we want to calculate. Instead of 1, we have 8. Then for 60 degrees, a little bit less than 8, and for 30 degrees, half of 8. Now, since this is supposed to be the difference of the previous column, we want to reconstruct the left-hand column by forming the cumulative sum. And I'll quickly mention why we start with 4, which is half of 8. But then 4 plus 7 is 11, 11 plus 4 is 15. And then way down on the next column, 0 plus 15 is 15, 15 plus 11 is 36, 36 plus 4 is 30. So why do we cut the last element of the beginning column into 2? Since, well, if this is supposed to be a sine, this is a cosine, and the cosine is anisometric with respect to 90 degrees. So if we continue the table, we should have minus 4 here, and the difference between those two must be 8, so 4 must be the half of 8. So that's how you work from right to left until you're satisfied. And you see, it's very simple to do by hand. You just need to accumulate very small integers. Now, we expect to find the final sign values in the leftmost column. However, this is by far not the sine of 90 degrees. This is a large integer number. But why don't we just normalize to divide everything by this number? Then we get the 1 here, we get 1 half here, which is sine of 30 degrees, and we get 5,042 divided by 5022, and this should be an approximation for sine of 60 degrees. So let's have a look at the approximations generated for 60 degrees. 7 over 8, then 26 over 30, and so on. And this is on the, well, by the way, this is a short interruption, the graph of a sine, first derivative, a cosine, second derivative, minus derivative, minus sine. But here we see these approximations, namely 7/8. We list the differences to root of 3 over 2. Here is the error is this. The error here is 26 over 30 minus root 3 over 2 is this. And it gets very much, gets quickly smaller. The quotient of two subsequent errors is about 14. And we will see later that is the limit of this quotient is 7 plus 4 times root of 3. So this is what we know about Mirby's algorithm, how he did the calculation. And in order to understand it, we need to consider now the difference table of the sine function. Here we list the arguments with differences 2 delta, x minus 2 delta, x and x plus 2 deltas, then the signs here. And here are the first differences, as your others. Second differences. Now the second difference on the same level as the function value sine of x is just a multiple of sine x. So like the second derivative of a sine function is minus sine. But the second, 5 minutes, thank you. The second derivative is a multiple, but not with a negative factor, but not the factor is not minus one. So Birdy's main result is mentioned here. For almost arbitrary initial column, the odd columns converge to the sine values we want to calculate after normalization. Now I have to go rather quickly through the linear algebra, which would explain all this and give a theory. The algorithm could be represented with vectors and matrices by multiplication with upper triangular matrices or lower triangular matrices filled with ones, and then the transformation from the rightmost column to the third column, which we call C, is a multiplication by the matrix M. And the matrix M for n equals 5 is this matrix. And the Birdy's algorithm just repeats multiplication of the approximation vector we start with by this matrix. Now this multiplication of vector always by the same matrix is called the power iteration for getting eigenvalues. So actually the Birdy algorithm is just a method for approximating the eigenvalues of the Birdy matrix in several steps, and all we have to do is diagonalize the Birdy matrix in order to know something about the eigenvalues, and it turns out that the diagonalization of the Birdy matrix and with a matrix V containing the eigenvectors and V a diagonal matrix can be done explicitly, whereas the matrix B is this and the diagonal matrix of the eigenvectors is this. Now it looks like my time is almost over, so I just summarize the results of these calculations if you go further on. The convergence factor, namely the ratio between two consecutive errors of a certain result in the Birdy table, is that the ratio between two consecutive errors is the convergence factor. And this convergence factor can be calculated by the ratio of two eigenvalues of which we know explicit formulas. It's namely the first eigenvalue divided by the first eigenvalue corresponding to a non-zero initial condition. Now let's quickly have a look at this. The example we were using, sine 30 degrees, 60 degrees, and 90 degrees, started with this initial vector. And it turns out that the second modified initial value is zero, so the third one is essential, and the convergence ratio is lambda 1 over lambda 3, first eigenvalue divided by third eigenvalue, and it's sine square of 75 degrees divided by sine square of 50 degrees, and this is this number which we estimated already. Birdy's example starts with this approximation for integer multiples of assigned values, also has a zero, an initial value, and gets a convergence factor of 23.5. So in Burgi's algorithm, every column is, the area in every column is reduced by a factor of 23, so you get 1.5 digits more by each step. And we could add more examples, but let me quickly go to the end. Unfortunately, I have written this already last year, so I couldn't submit it for these papers, but the publication is in Elements of Mathematics, 2016, number 71, and the title is the same as the title I announced for this talk. Thank you very much.